follow. Born on mild breezes and warm spring rains, lush grasses and many foals and calves fill the pastures of Lynn. In summer, the noon sun shimmers on the ripening sheaves of grain as on a golden ocean. In fall, the harvests are plentiful, and herds of horses and cattle brought down from the high mountain meadows cover the plains. In the long, cold nights of winter, the people of Ling sleep secure in their warm beds, untroubled by want or fear. Their life together is harmonious, and their disputes few. In midwinter, late on a glittering, frozen, starlit night, when the new crescent moon has just returned to the sky, and Gezar sleeps dreamlessly in his palace bedroom, the goddess Manene comes to him. Her skin is the color of pearl, and she rides on a white lion and leads a buffalo behind her. In one hand, she holds a bow, and in the other, a mirror. She descends across a bridge of faint moonlight, arching down from the lower point of the crescent moon directly into his heart. There, she takes her place and sings to him. Manene's song is heard only by Gezar, and tears fill his eyes as she glides up the moonlight bridge, leaving a hollow sadness in his heart. The next morning, at first light, Gazer dresses himself in full armor and calls for his horse to be outfitted for a long expedition. Gazer then assembles the people of Lane, tells them that he must overcome the heretic Titicus, and that he must accomplish this deed alone and unaided. His mother, his wife, his fellow warriors, and all the people accompany him to the border and weep when he leaves the lands of Lane.